As of March 16th of 2025, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of the three actively erupting shield volcanoes at the present is Hawaii's Kilauea volcano, which is located on the southeast portion of the Big Island. While it might not be actively outputting large volumes of lava at the present, it is indeed still erupting, hence the orange glow from shallow magma in this footage. Since December 23rd of 2024, Kilauea has produced 13 episodes of lava fountaining, which lasted anywhere from 13 hours to 8.5 days in length. The 13th such episode lasted for 13 hours on March 11th, generating spectacular lava fountain heights of 525 feet or 160 meters. A 14th episode is now expected to begin between March 18th and March 20th of 2025. This eruptive series has distributed fairly large amounts of tephra near the southwestern caldera rim edge, as you can see in these images. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, the Raung volcano produced a new, albeit brief, explosive eruption, sending a plume of ash 1,500 meters above its summit. While that occurred on Java, volcanic unrest occurred at another complex on the island of Sumatra as the Kerinci volcano produced a spike in both tremor and the rate of volcanic earthquakes. And in what is this week's top story, in Argentina, an unusually strong earthquake swarm occurred at a scenic and symmetrical volcano which many locals incorrectly think is extinct. However, the relevant Lanin volcano is still active, just not as much as its neighbor Villarrica, which has an active lava lake and is thus currently erupting 45 kilometers to the west-northwest. For reference, this Argentine volcano, Lanin, last erupted around 1500 years ago, and during the Holocene, or since 9700 BCE, has covered this area, or 47.33 square kilometers, in a layer of lava. Despite this, Lanin has almost been completely quiet throughout modern times, albeit with a brief earthquake swarm on February 15th of 2017. That swarm involved 59 earthquakes across a period of 45 minutes. Well, on March 13th of 2025, another such brief but intense earthquake swarm was observed. Beginning at 11:08 p.m. local time, dozens of earthquakes began striking one after the other beneath a glaciated portion of its northern flank. None of these earthquakes were larger than magnitude 2, meaning they were all micro-earthquakes, but across the next 5 hours, a total of 62 earthquakes struck, although this did not occur alongside any other activity. Seismicity returned to normal levels after the fact, leaving us pondering what caused this swarm. I personally suspect the movement of hydrothermal fluids as a source rather than magma, but this is just pure speculation. Heading over to the island of Java, a somewhat unexpected eruption occurred at Mount Raung, whose name translates to Roaring Mountain. The natural amphitheater shape of its summit caldera, combined with a very loud Strombolian and Vulcanian eruptions it produces, leads to this name. Well, on March 13th, Raung erupted once again, although no magma was involved. Instead, a phreatic eruption involving the explosive ejection of steam and ash occurred across a period of 34 seconds, sending a plume of ash 1,500 meters above its summit. This marked the first eruption of Raung since December 24th of last year, and based on its pattern of recent eruptions, we can probably expect additional small magnitude eruptions to originate from its central summit crater during the next few weeks. Meanwhile, on Sumatra, the tallest and one of the most active volcanoes on the island, Mount Kerinci, seems to be undergoing an episode of unrest. This unrest began at 4:30 p.m. local time on March 14th, involving dozens of distinctively volcanic earthquakes beneath its summit. Later in the evening, at 8:43 p.m., continuous tremor occurred for a time, which in my opinion suggests the movement of gas, fluids, or magma. Thus, now with an increased summit gas plume and still ongoing tremor as of the writing of this video, it seems that the odds of a lower-end explosive eruption at Mount Kerinci has temporarily increased, hence the 3-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions around its summit. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on March 15th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Joan Bachman, for supporting this channel.